just looking for a police officer, you know, which is a crazy thing anyway, because they're normally fucking looking for me. You lost your finger roofing in the service of this fucking country, and here you are on the street selling the big issue.
Sack down,
dude. Come here, where are you going?
Where are you going?
I just fucking walk off.
Shut up, mate. I'm having a fucking coffee.
They look at us like we fucking scum at the bottom of their shoes.
Sweet man, please.
A cuddle.
A cuddle? I'll give you a cuddle, mate. Really, madam, I can't understand how you can even sleep at night. Do you think, as an Israeli, do you think that it's fair for Israel to have nuclear weapons, but not, say, Iran?
Yes.
Alright, Lil, what's happening? Say something. Lil.
I'm in fucking Times Square.
Nice to have the name up there, you know what I mean? New York International Film Festival. I'm Bill Maloney, the director. We've been in this place and it's happened to us before. We're trying to put posters up. We do make independent films. Fuck off. So if there was one thing that you could change, what would you change?
I would change the attitude of the rich people. To think that Harlem is a bad place.
They allow crime and violence to exist in America because it's profitable.
Because it's profitable. You live here in Harlem? Yeah. Are things bad here or things good here or they get better? They're bad here. They're bad for you, baby. No, wait till I start moving. Wait till I start going. This is Bill Maloney's. Come up here. I'm on the street. Now, no war. Look at this. This is outside Westminster. This is fucking great. Peace. These people are living here. This is what it's all about. Look at this. Caution, police state in operation. So I'm not the only one who fucking thinks like that. These people are living here and they're fighting. These people have been here a long time. And I should imagine they've had all sorts of journalists. And I should imagine they've had all sorts of people coming here, good and bad. Brown nose. Fucking right, mate. I'm on your side, mate. Don't dig me out just yet. True democracy is not for dumb, cowardly sheep. Now, you know, these people, yeah, he's got another one. You vote for you, and I vote for me. Then we'll have true democracy. That's nice, mate. My name's Bill Maloney, mate. I'm a film director. I've got a film at the New York International Film Festival, and I represent the lower working class genre. So what you're doing here, I mean, you know, there's all different kind of wars going on, mate. You got people in this country, they can't get a fucking dentist, mate. You got people in this country that can't get a CAT scan. You understand? Margaret Thatcher stopped the fucking milk, you know? And now, look at the opulence of this building. It's like, it blows me away.
It's protection and preservation of all life. I belong to a parasitic life form that is devoiding its host planet of the ability to support life. I need to belong to a symbiotic life form that is supporting all the life on its host planet.
Right, now listen, mate, there's a lot of people that won't understand what you're fucking talking about there, and they're going to say you're crackers, but they say that about me. And just by that, you're an artist, you know what I mean? And at least you're struggling for a voice, and I hope you get it, and I'm just going to move along here, mate, and talk to some other people. What's your name?
I go by the handle of Friend.
Friend will do me.
Everything.
Fucking hell, friend, it's a big man. This is a big man. Now, we need big men like Friend, you know what I mean? Friend, I can't stand the establishment. I can't stand the fucking establishment, Friend. I really can't. I think that they are so oppressive. Their features and everything about them and what they do seems to be demonic. And, you know, the Freemasonry, etc., etc. And the Queen, you know. I've never heard the Queen speak without a fucking speech. So we don't even know if she can speak without a speech. Hello, everyone. I'm a filmmaker. My name's Bill Maloney. No, not interested, mate. Aye. bit tired, mate. Listen, I've seen you a couple of times, mate. I know you've been here a long time, haven't you?
I've been here 7 years. You've been here 24/7, that's why I'm a bit tired. Yeah. You know? So, I mean, I've got quite a bit to do, actually.
Yeah. You know? But we agree with you. You know what I mean? Here, see this. See this. You know, it was only up to a year ago when
we still had more troops
in Iraq. Then, listen, just give me a minute, mate. I know you're angry, mate.
No, I don't have space. You don't know what you've interrupted, do you? You don't know what we're doing.
Well, that's right. Okay, mate. Well, fair enough. If we can't talk, we can't talk. You're doing to me what these people have been doing to my people for fucking years. You're oppressing and turning me away.
You just told me fuck off.
That's fuck off in my language, and I'm going.
You don't know what you're interrupting, do you? You don't know what we're doing.
I'm only here to talk to you, mate.
No, I know, because your issue, what you're doing, is all number one.
Shouldn't like-minded people stay together?
Well, you ain't together. You ain't with us when the police were attacking us outside our parliament.
Well, mate, I've done 15 fucking years in this fucking institution's nick. 15 years. By the time I was 20, I turned 15 years. Don't fucking talk to me, you sausage gun. Fuck off, you. Who you standing up with me? I've done 15 fucking years, cunt. My parents are fucking Irish, and my sister lived on the street for 20 years. You fuck yourself, cunt. Where are you from? Australia. I've done 15 fucking years. Don't you talk to me. I suppose you have. Fuck off. Cut. Oh, fuck it. Oi, cut. 15 years in these nicks I've done, and we still got as many troops on the streets of Northern Ireland as we got in fucking Iraq. Cut. And my mother was a fucking brass cut. Who tucked you in at night? You go fuck yourself. Sorry about that. All right, girls, what's happening? I'm talking here. So, I got a little bit angry with a guy, you know. I started shouting about my imprisonment in this country's institutions and about how we still got troops on the streets in Northern Ireland. And then I'm talking about my mother, who was a prostitute. And then I started screaming at him that my sister had lived on the streets. My sister lived on the streets for 19 fucking years. And then I could have gone in about my brother Peter, who killed himself, and all my other fucking brothers and sisters that were fucked about in this country's institutions. You know, and what's going on at the moment out in Jersey with the kids. But I never. I could have broke his fucking jaw, but I never. Because, believe it or not, I'm a pacifist. I don't mind shouting, I don't mind talking, I'll debate with anyone. But when they start talking to me like that, and especially putting a woman in front of him to come and try and deal with me, that really fucked me off, you know what I mean? And I think that because he's been there and he's had quite a bit of media interest in him, he's forgotten what he's there for, and he's becoming a fucking celebrity himself. So I'm not going to say so any more about this geezer. Good luck to him, and good luck with him getting the troops out of Iraq. But you won't get the troops out of Iraq as long as there's fucking oil there, and that's all there is to it. And what I think we should do is get the Saudis to bring down the price of oil. Maybe the Queen could go over and shake hands with them again and get them to do us a favour. That's what we fucking need in this country. Cut that.
Peace campaigner Brian Hoare has persistently been targeted by the police establishment. Brian has lived on the pavement for 7 years. After Billy's altercation with Brian, he informed Lily and Darren that Brian and his female colleague were to be absolutely respected. Pie and Mash Films decided to keep the scene in to show that like-minded people, Billy and Brian, got it wrong that day.
This is in Trafalgar Square, there's fucking Nelson's Column, this is our fucking democracy. Right, this is Will, look where he's sleeping. Look where he's sleeping in this fucking rich country of ours. What's happened? What's your story?
The real truth is, right, it's the police, mate.
It's the police?
I broke the law once, and all they've ever done to me since 1993 is sorry for swearing.
That's all right, say what you want.
They've fucked my life up, mate.
What, the old Bill?
Yeah.
How long you been on the streets, Will?
Since 1993, and I remember the date exactly, February the 2nd.
So where do you sleep at night, here?
Any shop doorway on the street, my brother.
Anywhere you can. And
yeah.
What did you do before you hit the street, Will?
I used to be an old army marine. I'm an ex-marine, mate.
You're an ex-marine and you're sleeping on the fucking streets. Did you do Ireland? Did you serve in Northern Ireland?
Yes, I was in all.
So you served in Northern Ireland?
I've done my little bit of career and I've done my bits, yes, and right. I don't get fuck all.
Nothing? No. What problems have you got? You got any mental health problems or anything like that, Will? Yeah, what is it? What have they classed you as?
Suicidal and a raving lunatic.
Suicidal and a raving lunatic? A raving lunatic. They didn't mind you in the army though, Will, when they wanted to fucking use you, did they?
No, I'm probably the frontline soldier.
Yeah, frontline soldier. Well, that's the fucking democracy, Will. And here you are, what's really pulled me in, put it on me, what's really pulled me in today is that this is Trafalgar Square and Will is kipping on the fucking street. What's going on here then, eh? And in a minute I'm gonna come and see you, Your Majesty, up at Buckingham Palace. Nice one. Will, take that. It ain't a lot, but we're on a low budget, you know what I mean? Good luck, Will.
I'm gonna say this for you. I've got to do this for the camera.
Do it.
I don't give a fuck. Ask me a question and who do I think of? This is for you, Tony Blair, and Gordon Brown. You got me, now, ain't you?
There they are. Here they go, look. Taxi. There he goes.
Taxi.
Let's have the camera on me. Here they go with their fucking show of force. I've just seen them riding around here the same as they do in other places around the world as a show of force, and they put the fucking boot on the back of our necks. And let me tell you something. See these police officers? Their entrance exam is not even equivalent to a fucking GCSE. You know what I mean? Respect for you people? I don't think so. Thank you very much, Will. Oi, these are the fucking people that touch me. Nice one, Will.
This is real world.
I know that, mate.
They look at us like we fucking scum on the bottom of their shoes.
Now, you are support officers. So what we see you as in this country at the moment, oh, we've been tracing you, is you deserve to have a lot more power than what you've given. It's no good just giving you nice uniforms. What powers do you need so you can help us on the street more?
I can't say anything to that. It's not for me to decide.
Right, but you must have opinions because you're here because you want to help the public and you want to do good, yeah? That's how we see you. But what could we do to give you, what powers could we give to help you in your quest?
It's not really for me to decide. It's a bit of now, isn't it?
Yeah?
No.
What do you think? You personally, do you think that the streets of London are becoming more safer?
Yeah.
You do? So, and that could be attributed to you. But so, I would believe as a filmmaker that you need to get some opinions so that you can say, yeah, this is why I'm doing it and that's why I'm doing it. Or why are you doing it?
I'm off for a second.
That's all right. That's pucker, mate. Thank you very much, chaps. They don't know why they're doing the fucking job. They don't know why they're doing the job. They don't know what powers they want. They don't know fuck all. That's the establishment for you. Strange, eh? So what, was you living in council accommodation?
Yeah, I was living in private accommodation with my partner.
Yeah.
It was in her accommodation.
It was her place. You have kids with her?
Two
kids. So when it all went wonky, you got kicked out on the fucking street. And no council or anyone would help you and give you
single
a home?
Bloke. I'm a single young bloke. I was 22. Single young bloke, so basically you've got to fend for yourself.
So the establishment hasn't really structured anything in the favour of the single young man?
I'm not pregnant, I'm not mixed-race, I'm not an immigrant.
Yeah, I'm not, you speak freely, yeah.
So basically I'm not from a war-torn, country,
yeah.
So I can't get anything. I've not got no, like, personal, like, big major problems in my life that
Right. Have you ever been to prison?
Yeah, I've been to prison when I was younger.
What was that for, Chris?
Stealing cars, just messing around.
Petty crime. Just being a kid.
Yeah.
And what part of London do you come from?
Hackney.
You are a Hackney boy. Well, you're the second geezer I've met from Hackney. I used to play football over there as well.
Yeah.
Hackney Marshes.
Hackney Marshes, yeah.
But what happened to, like, a lot of the playing fields, especially around South London and places like that? The councils sold off the playing fields so that they could bolster up their fucking pensions and their exorbitant
right, you know what I mean? Yeah,
and now we've got institutions that are just not working in this country, Chris.
Yeah.
You know, the probation service is fucked. The social services are fucked. You know, you get so many social workers, they come out of fucking university. They got no kids, though.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? But because they got a fucking degree, the prick who's in charge will say, oh, yeah, one of my kind.
Yeah,
nice one, Chris. Nice talking to you.
Right,
give me some money. You got a ching or something?
Youth clubs over there in Hackney, they've all been shut down.
All your youth clubs have been shut down? So everything's been shut down?
As I was growing up, all the youth clubs got...
How'd you lose your finger?
That's from roofing.
for roofing. Yeah. Let's have a look at that. So you lost your finger roofing in the service in this fucking country, and here you are on the street selling the big issue.
Yeah, that's right. It's like that, yeah.
Cheers, Chris.
Right.
Good luck, mate. Good luck. Oh, let me ask you one question. What's the minimum wage in this country? What's the minimum wage in this country?
Country?
No, this country.
Yes.
Where do you come from?
France.
Ah, Jean Doble. Catholic? Thank
yes.
God. Your English is, you need to pick up on your English a little bit. What is the minimum wage in this country? How much do you get paid?
Difference.
Difference?
Yeah.
So, but in this job, how much do they pay you an hour?
1 hour?
Yeah, 1 hour. How much?
£6. 50.
£6?
Yes.
That's above the minimum wage. What's your name?
Arco.
Arco,
yes.
Arco. Nice to meet you, Arco. Good luck. It's 20 to 1, and we got here around about 11 o'clock. And I'm just looking for a police officer, you know, which is a crazy thing anyway, because they're normally fucking looking for me. But we can't find a police officer anywhere, so... It all seems all lovely, but you know, with all the terrorism and that, I think there should be some police officers. This couple look comfortable. Good morning. You know, I'm just looking for a police officer. Because I've been here, I've come up from southeast London, and I've been up here since 11 o'clock and it's near 12:45. And because you know, like what's going on, hello mate, you know what's going on with Al Qaeda, I'm thinking, where's the old Bill?
Watching us there,
oh, it's all on camera.
I'm sure they're watching us.
Yeah,
now.
Well, you know what I mean, mate. We still need to know what's all this about Al Qaeda. You know what I mean? I've just been down in Trafalgar Square, and I've got these people sleeping in Trafalgar Square, but there's no police officers. And you know, like this terrorism thing that they're all trying to frighten us with. Where are they? No, the terrorists have gone.
5 minutes ago, a police officer passed here.
Right, here we are. We've got two witnesses. Can we use them? We've got two witnesses. These people saw a police officer 5 minutes ago.
Yes.
Just the one?
One.
Only one?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Listen, a police officer walking about on his own with all these terrorists and Al-Qaeda everywhere, you know what I mean? And just one on his own. That's a brave man. Okay, let's find this police officer. I want to search the streets of London, Soho. What's he doing in Soho anyway? Did he have a particular kind of walk? Because, you know, Soho isn't just a happy place, it's a gay place as well. Right, so the police, they'll come into Soho, but they won't go anywhere else. You know what I mean? Maybe that's an exclusive club, chaps. Thank you very much.
A good service already.
You think so?
Yeah, you should be wearing a uniform.
I should be wearing a uniform.
Yeah, you're doing a good service. You're doing the job.
I'm not wearing the uniforms. Listen, I'll save my uniforms for the bedroom.
You're a man of many talents.
Thank you very much. You're all right yourself.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
Yeah.
Sweden. What's this you're smoking?
She shop.
She shop. What's your name? You guys say that again?
Nazreen and Mona, yeah.
Nazreen and Mono?
Mona.
Mona, I thought, alright, Mona.
What's this for?
Because you're good looking girls, and like, this is like, where we are in Soho, and you're sitting here, this is what we call a hubba bubba pipe, yeah? And I've smoked it myself, you know what I mean? And I don't see anything wrong with this, and it is a culture. So, you know, I just say, like, whenever I see anyone practicing a culture, I think, good luck.
Yeah.
Good luck. Power, you know what I mean?
Done it, yeah.
Give me it. Nice, darling.
Yeah.
Give it a lotion one. Bye, girls. Lovely.
Oh, nice.
And you?
Yeah.
Do you got smoke coming out of your nose and everything? You look like my mother-in-law. She looks like my mother-in-law with fucking smoke coming out of her nose like a dragon. Love ya. No, mate.
Ben.
My name's Bill. I don't, Ben, Bill and Ben, fucking hell, well done, Ben.
Doing up the flower pot, man.
Ben, where'd you come from originally?
I'm from London.
So, how much do you get a week?
£59.
£59. And what's that for?
To live.
To live?
Yeah, to eat, live, survive for 7 days a week.
And where do you live?
Yeah.
On the street?
Yeah.
What you got in this bag? Your sleeping bag and that?
Yeah.
So, oh, this is your home on your back?
Yeah.
And you are born and bred British. What did your dad do for a living?
Carpenter.
Your dad was a carpenter? So that's what I'm talking about, the demise of the lower working class British culture, i.e. Yep. carpenters. And in the old days, you would have probably been a carpenter and be comfortable, Ben. Yep. So you took this route, you hit the street. Why?
Drugs, drink, you name it. I had nothing better to do.
Right, so we just had a budget, or we got a budget coming up. So you are hooked on drink and drugs, right? Which the government, just like a drugs dealer, you know what happens? Cocaine, when they get you hooked and then they put the price up. So they got you hooked on the drink, this government of ours, and now they're putting your price up. So they're pimping and dealing to you.
Yeah.
What's your dream, Ben? What is your dream, your aspiration?
To get out of this, man. Get out of this shit and get something better.
Yeah, what did you want to do when you was at school?
Wanted to be, well, not like everyone else, but I don't know, when you were a little kid you wanted to be rich, famous and all that bunch, but now I look at it and I think, nah, yeah. I don't want that.
What about the celebrities? Do you look up to them? Do you aspire to them still?
Do I fuck?
No.
They've got all this and all that. They don't give nothing to no one, bro. They don't give a fuck. It's like you and me, I help my fellow homeless people, they help me.
So it's a family, it's a community, it's become a culture.
These people walking past now, they don't give a fuck.
Of course they don't.
They've got that in their pocket, they don't give a shit, bro.
Yeah. Oh, but we're all so close to the edge, Ben, you know what I mean? So your day will come. Ben, nice talking to you. It's park up.
It happens. You have poverty. I mean, America's so large.
But it's the richest country on the planet.
It is the richest country on the planet, but like I'm saying, the budget's normally going to Iraq. Most of the currency is currently going to Iraq or any type of war.
That's right. But black people in this country are treated better in this country than in your country, and you're the richest one.
But the thing is, right, the thing about America is that every president or every American is hypnotizing, thinking that everything outside America is socialist.
Hypnotizing who?
Huh? All Americans, the president.
So you're all hypnotized. You're being hypnotized.
Yeah, we are hypnotized in some way. We can't, if we say we want free universal health care, we can't, because then every other person who's rich or a CEO of a health care will say, no, that's socialist.
Right.
The president will go, that's socialist. We're not going to deal with anything that's not American.
Right.
Anything that's
so what's American? Is it Republican?
It's Democratic.
Democratic. Well, where's the democracy in that? Why should the rich people of Manhattan have so much money, and yet when you go down to Harlem, which is only a few miles away, and sometimes 400 meters away from Columbia University?
No, it is, and it's pretty corrupted. But the thing is about America, it's the land of the free.
What's your name?
I'm busy, mate.
No, but no, that's all right. There's no problem.
Sorry.
No, I don't want to be filmed. But you're Polish, yeah?
My manager, okay.
Ah, okay, mate. All right, bye. You know, stay on me. This is a Polish guy. He's frightened to talk.
Yeah.
This is England. He's frightened to talk. Nice to see you again, son. It's called Lunatic. Check that fucking film out, son, because I'm going to kill you next time if you ain't seen it. Adios amigo.
I like you.
You like me?
Yeah, I do.
This geezer likes me.
I do.
So, can you do a little bit on my hand? So listen, here we are, we're talking to Suggs. Yeah. Now me and Suggs, when we first met, we didn't hit it off that much, but now we love each other because he's going to buy the film Lunatic.
What?
And he's even said that we can get him and ask him questions on it and everything, and he'll have written... Yeah,
I've done it all. Yeah, I've finished the questionnaire's done. It's in the post.
Yeah, and that's it. And all joking aside, Suggs probably comes from a similar background as me. So
yes.
Please, go, yes, he says. So yes. So just
love
say,
it, mate. You know
do me one thing, Suggs. Just say, Pine Mesh Films, love it.
Pine Mesh Films. Love it.
You can do better than that.
No, I could.
Let me direct you, Suggs. Pine Mesh Films, love it. Say it, love it. Just say love it. Ah, he swore. Say
love it.
That'll do.
Nice, mate. Give me that one,
isn't
it, Suggs?
Sweet.
All day long.
Bye, mate. And yours.
All favour to them.
Yeah. I don't know about that. So you're the same as a warden?
Yeah.
So, we've been talking about, hearing people talking about the powers that you have as a warden or whatever.
Yeah.
What powers
can I just
have
stop you?
Yeah.
I'm not supposed to give interviews without permission of Westminster Council.
Oh.
Sorry.
Yeah,
I can't go any further with
mate,
that.
Mate, I'm just a poor, ignorant Cockney boy.
Okay, no
you know what I mean? So I'm just asking, but you're not allowed to give an interview,
no,
I respect
without,
that.
Not without my
without
colleagues.
Permission.
Yeah.
Fair enough, mate. That's democracy.
Okay.
Sweet, mate. Thank you. So, Michael, you're from Poland?
Yep.
How long, don't look at the camera, Michael. How long have you been over here?
9 years.
9 years, and you're living on the streets?
Yeah.
Or are you a professional beggar?
No, I'm not professional.
You're not? You're just living on the streets?
Yeah.
So, dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry.
Jane Dobre.
Jane Dobre. Now, Michael, why are you living on the streets?
I used to have a drug problem. I'm honest, isn't it?
Yeah, you be honest, Michael. You had a drug problem?
Yeah, I used to have a drug problem.
Right.
I'm on a methadone now.
Ah, what was it, heroin?
Heroin,
yeah. So you was a heroin addict, Michael?
I used to be heroin.
Well, that was a tough life.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I know, well, I'm guessing that you're a Catholic.
Yeah, I'm a Catholic.
How does your religion help you?
Actually, no, I don't really believe, you know. I'm a Catholic, but I don't really go to church.
But do you believe? Do you believe in what you was taught as a Catholic?
Yeah, I believe, yeah.
You believe in Jesus Christ,
yeah,
Mary?
We must believe something, you know. If you don't believe nothing, we're fucked, innit?
You think so? If we haven't got any faith, we're fucked. Then there'd be trouble.
So I used to take drugs for 11 years. You know, I lost my daughter. Actually, I have a daughter, a 6-year-old daughter, yeah?
Yeah.
But I lost my family, I lost my daughter.
Where's your family, Michael?
My girlfriend is here, my daughter is here, but because I've been on the drugs and my girlfriend don't want to talk to me.
What do you think of England?
It's all right, yeah.
So you're in England, you're Polish, you're on the streets, your family won't talk to you, and you've lost your daughter. Because of drugs.
Yeah.
Now, all I can do is give you that, Michael, and wish you the best. And maybe, like, things will go good for you. All right, Michael, nice. My name's Bill Maloney, and I work for a film company called Pie Mash Films, and I'm interested in people's struggle, wherever they come from. Nice, Michael. Could you say into there, Michael, Pie Mash Films, love it.
Pie Mash Films, love it.
Nice, Michael. What's happening is, we're waiting to find out if we've got our budget so that we can go to New York with the film Lunatic. Lunatic's been chosen for the New York International Film Festival. And it's a cracking film, and it's being accepted out there very strongly, you know. People seem to like it. But we're all a little bit upset because on the camera we got Darren. Now, we've been told we've got enough budget for two of us to go out, which is myself and Lilly. If you want to go show Lilly. Okay, Lily's still a bit angry, you know, we had a little altercation earlier, because in this business, it's so fucking ambiguous, you know what I mean? One minute you're doing something, next minute you ain't. One minute you got a budget, then you ain't got a budget. One minute you got a budget, and then the producers will say, listen, the investors don't want you to say this, don't want you to talk about that. So, we're going on fuck all, really. So while we wait, I'm still shooting documentary on the streets of London because I'm very interested in rich, poor, and especially the demise of the lower working class culture, which rebuilt this country on more than one occasion, and are now being told to go fuck themselves while the middle, upper classes bring in cheap labour from all around Europe to look after their property and their health and whatever else they can use them for. And the lower working class is, that culture is being told, go fuck yourself, we're finished with you. There's nothing in the bank for us. There's nothing in the bank for us. We get state pensions, that's what we get. We got no company pensions. We're not worried about Northern Rock collapsing, all these other bollocks. That's for people who have bank accounts. I'm talking about people who can't even get a fucking bank account. People who never had an education, or rather an indoctrination rather than a fucking education. And that's what makes me angry, you know what I mean? When I see the opulence walking around about this country, and especially the complete and absolute rip-off prices. Most people don't know what the minimum wage is, you know? We're supposed to have a 40-hour working week in this country, but if the minimum wage is £5.20 an hour, that means you've got to work 10 hours to earn £50 and £52. And out of that £52, you're going to be paying your fucking taxes and your social fucking this and social fucking that. So that's what I'm doing. Anyway, and while I'm doing that out in New York, we wanted Darren to keep dog eye so that if anyone wanted to shoot me in the head, that he would be able to give me some kind of little warning. But now our budget won't push to Darren, our cameraman, so it looks like that Lily's going to have to shoot the camera, and she's not looking forward to that. So this may be the one chance you get to see the cameraman, so I'm going to show you. Hello, Darren.
Hello.
How do you feel about not being able to come to New York?
Well, I'm pissed off, you know, but there you go, I'm going to have to stay here and so I should do that,
really. If we was working for 20th Century Fox or Paramount,
I'd be out there already, do you know what I mean?
You'd be out there already.
I'd be sitting there on the Sun Lounger with everyone fussing around me, but I don't want all that, it's fucking bollocks.
Yeah, so, yeah. Well, cheer up and don't get too angry.
I won't.
Yeah, take the camera back.
They come back on me.
There's a geezer over there, and he's been watching us, and his mate just took some photos of us.
he's one of those wardens or guardian angels, whatever they want to call themselves. And I was talking to one yesterday and he didn't really like what I said. I'm not sure if that's him or not, but he's just cracked off a couple of snaps of us and now he's talking to someone on the phone. So we don't know what's going to happen here, if anything. Thank God we're in England. I'm a filmmaker.
Oh, okay.
And I'm going around doing a documentary. I'm talking about the lower working class and the demise of the culture, you know. I noticed you've got Guardian. I prefer that name to Warden, because Warden is a little bit too establishment orientated for me.
It is.
Yeah. But Guardian, because they've got the Guardian Angels in America. So I could see that.
That's the one, yeah. I mean, Guardian's been in London now, in Westminster, for the past just over 3 years. In terms of what you're asking me, unfortunately, you're going to have to go through my media department because obviously I can't give any kind of comment.
Oh, boy. All this establishment bollocks is why people who are living on the fucking street can't get a fucking dentist, can't get a CAT scan.
He's right. I'm on the street 6 years out here.
Let's have him.
I've got fuck all.
What's your name, mate?
Martin.
Martin?
Yeah.
Why are you dressed like a Chinaman, Martin?
Because I'm selling Chinese big issues.
Right, so you're selling Chinese big issues. That's not a big issue, though, is it?
I know.
Right, Martin. So what's your story? How long have you been on the streets?
6 years.
And how much do you get off the government every week?
£46 a week.
£46?
Yeah.
What's that for? Just
incapacity illness benefit.
Incapacity illness? So why don't you get no more than that? Because you've got no... Are you of no fixed abode? So where do you sleep?
Home.
You're joking?
No.
What, in this fucking rich country?
Yeah.
What do you think about that, Martin?
Because, you see, I was a very rich multi-millionaire, Richard Branson. Guess who put me out of business?
Who?
Richard Branson.
And what was you doing?
Airline. And he Shamrock Airlines, he screwed me into the
Shamrock
ground.
Shamrock Airlines?
Yeah, and he screwed me into the ground so... And his fare so... I couldn't make a living.
What are you? What drugs are you? Are you on Prozac or anything like that?
No, nothing like that.
Are you a manic depressive or anything like that?
Bipolar,
so. You got bipolar, that's all. Well, that's a pretty scary thing, bipolar, innit? That is sort of a depression, innit?
Yeah.
You have suicidal tendencies?
A bit now and again.
Now and again. Is that a product, a byproduct of, like, the bipolar? Is that...
Yeah, yeah.
So that is inherent with the bipolar suicidal. Yeah. Well, don't do it. And I'll tell you what, have you tried it a few times? Well, you ain't very fucking good at it, Martin, are you?
But
good luck, Martin.
I'm living with the rats down at Victoria Street.
Well,
got an alleyway.
Better than living with the rats in Westminster, eh? Nice one, Martin. It's been a pleasure. Give this man some money.
That's the best one.
Thank you.
Low budget.
No. Good luck, Martin. You look pucker anyway. Oh. And listen. The thing is.
That's for me, Dad.
Even if the British won't have him, the fucking Chinese will, you know what I mean? Well done, Martin. How long ago did you have your breakdown?
When I was about 21.
When you was 21? And how old are you now?
I'm 44 in a month's time.
Right, so you've had a breakdown at an early age. Was you brought up in care or anything like that?
I've been in care homes, yeah.
How much do you get a week? How much a week do you get off the government?
35 at the moment.
£35 a week to live on?
Yeah.
Yeah, but that isn't for your board and lodging, is it? That's just for you to live on?
That's, well, they're paying me the wrong benefit.
Why?
Because it doesn't cover the bed money.
They don't pay, so they're just paying you money like food money, but you're not getting no accommodation money at the moment. And that's why you've got to beg for your £7.
Yeah.
Right, what do you think of this government? What do you think of this government at the moment, the way they're treating the people of this country?
I don't do politics.
You don't do politics, but if you don't do politics, well, you've got to do politics and you've got to understand politics, otherwise you ain't understanding who's taking your money off you.
Ah.
Right, nice. Give this lady, how much is it?
£7.
Give her £7. And I'll pay for your bed for the night.
Thank you.
Now, you go to Westminster and try and get it that easy.
Nah.
Ain't gonna happen, is it?
Nah.
All right. Sweet pan, please.
Can I have a cuddle?
A cuddle? I'll give you a cuddle, mate. I'll give you a cuddle. Oh, fucking hell. Nice,
thank
sweet.
You.
Now go away, leave me alone.
All right.
All right, love ya.
Love ya.
All right, bye, darling. Now look at this woman. You see this woman on the street. She's living on the street. She's living on £35 a week, this woman. This is what I'm looking for, the demise of the British working class culture.
What the fuck is going on in this country? She only wants a cuddle. I'm in the middle of Soho where all the filmmakers are, making all the fucking money.
Look, I'm not interested in that. All I want to know is, have we got funding to take the film Lunatic out to New York? Yes or no? No, no, no. It's no good taking two people. It's no good taking two people. Two people ain't no fucking good. I need a camera person and I need my PA. That's three. Who's going to shoot the footage? Who's going to shoot it? Right, that's no good to me. You go back to that fucking prick and you tell him he's got to chuck in another $2,000 because we want to take three people out of fucking New York. Otherwise the film's dead or I ain't fucking going out there. Do you understand? We can go to New York, but we've only got the money for two people. Well, that's what they fucking said to me. I'm just waiting for a fucking phone call back,
anyway. Don't fucking jump down.
I'm not jumping down,
you're jumping down.
Oh, fuck off, oh, fuck off. Oh, take the fucking
off. Yeah, you fuck off. This bollocks, you fucking think of yourself.
Yeah, you get back. Wait, phone me. Yeah, you and all, bollocks. Lil! Lil! Lil, come here, where are you going? Just fucking walk off.
Shut up, me. I'm having a fucking coffee. I asked you what's wrong. You start fucking joking.
I'm trying to sort it out.
Sort it out, then. You'll see my boys.
Well, you want to see your boys? You can see your boys. I'm like trying to sort this fucking New York shit out.
Let me know, then. It's just like fucking drinking on at the moment.
Well, as soon as I get the money, then we can go. Well, don't keep walking away all the fucking time.
Stop talking to me now. I'm a fucking prick, then.
I'm not talking to you. I'm not. This is how we fucking work. As soon as I know. As soon as I know.
You're stressed.
As soon as I know, I'll tell you.
That's all I'm asking for, right?
What?
Share with me.
I'm not. What?
What? Share
with me
sometime.
Come on then. Out there.
Wait.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare.
Just for a minute.
Yeah, sure.
This dog, alright, this is a boxer, you know, because my dad was a boxer and his name's Bastard. So, this dog, this guy, look, get down, you bastard. Get up, you bastard. We love you, you bastard. Fuck off, you bastard. You know what I mean? This dog must keep you, this man alive. You know what I mean? He's pucker. He's a good boy and he loves me. Nice one, mate. What's your name?
Hamish.
Hamish? Hamish and Bastard.
That's it.
Alright, bye, Hamish. Bye.
Alright, mate. You English, mate? Right?
Huh?
I'm English.
You're not English? No. Oh, Polish?
Yeah, Polish.
Dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry.
How long you been over here?
Here?
Yeah.
3 years.
You like it here?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, the money's all right and all that? They're looking after you?
Yeah, man.
Well done.
Yeah.
That's the third road sweeper I've spoke to in Westminster. I haven't spoke to anymore. I've only spoke to three and they're all Polish. Now, you know, people are saying like the English, they won't do the jobs that these Poles will do or what the Albanians will do or what anyone will do. All right, mate. Listen, the reason the English won't do the fucking work is because you ain't paying them the right money. If you pay them the right money, you so-called professionals and you middle classes and upper classes, and the way you expect your money to have risen, how much has your wages gone up? Whatever you do, whatever you professionals do, just say since 2000, I bet it's gone up a lot more than the fucking lower working class wages. So don't say these are the jobs that the British won't do, because the British will do these jobs if you fucking pay them. Put the hand in the pocket. You punched off them long enough, now give them something back. Look on this door. Prostitution's meant to be illegal in this country, and what have we got? We got the fucking sexy Brazilian. So there we go. You know, prostitution isn't dead in this country. You can't get more blatant than that on the fucking front door. Where's the old building? Any kids about? You fucking wankers. This, I can't show you the label on this, but this is a drink that's available to children. Right? I'll give you a clue. Okay, bit of snot there. That's what it is, okay? Now, this puts your heart rate up by 20%, which to me is a fucking amphetamine.
That is an amphetamine, and your children can go out and buy it. So they don't mind that. And then all of a sudden, they started making Alco Pops. So the Alco Pops, so we make them all like lovely and sweet and red, and we make them irresistible to children, but we put a shot of alcohol in. Now, all our kids are fucking alcoholics and drug addicts. So, because we're kicking them off with the amphetamine, and then we're giving them the Alco Pops, you know what I mean? That's my little theory. Here they are. They're not moving, though. I don't know if they're watching me, watching them, or whether I'm watching them, watching me. I'm up the studio. It's the last night that Lil's going to see her boys before we go to New York, and then she won't see them for a couple of weeks. So they're dancing in there, and I'm going to go in and film them, and it's fucking quite heartbreaking for me. Here we go. Right, I've just come back out into the factory. I'm at the studio. She's staying the night with her boys, and I'm holding the camera. Look at this. Great, isn't it? It's the only time I really see that girl happy. When she's with her boys. Oh, National Catastrophe, £8.50. Our famous ice cream sundae made from freshly churned vanilla ice cream, marshmallows, hazelnuts, caramel meringue, cookie crumbs, fresh raspberry sauce, whipped cream, and chocolate sauce. Does it get any more dangerous, it says. Well, let's have that camera back on me. Now, I'll tell you what. Where I live, in South East London, I don't know anyone who could bring four kids up here and buy them a fucking National Catastrophe at £8.50 each. Just quickly, that works out about £34 for four children to have a National Catastrophe, i.e. ice cream. This place has got nothing to do with the people of England. This place is for the upper classes, for the nouveau riche. This has fuck all to do with the working classes of Great Britain who have built this country from fuck all on more than one occasion. And yes, it does make me angry. This is the National Gallery. National, nation, what fucking nation? Well, this makes me chuckle. We're talking about the security of this country. And as we look up here, we're telling people where the Jewel Tower is. Then we come round here a little bit and we're telling them where the war cabinet is. Great, that's good security, isn't it? And then just below the war cabinet, we've got WC, the toilets. So what do you think? So, you know, you terrorists, you can come over here. There's a sign here to tell you where all the jewels are being kept. And there's another sign to tell you where all the war cabinet, where they are, just that way. You just got to go that way. and the fucking Kazi. And I'll tell you what, the most important sign up there is the WC, the Kazi. Because there's nowhere to have a piss or a shit in London if you're a tourist. All right, chaps, what's happening? Looking smart today. Hey, are we earning money today, chaps? No? Don't tell fibs. I'll tell you what, they're earning more than him. All right, mate, get your bed. I just wanted to show you this, you know. I just got a police officer. Mate, I've already spoke to you. These have got to be lawyers. You've got to be lawyers, mate. You're a lawyer. You're a lawyer.
Now, what are you? What
are
you doing? I'm a filmmaker.
No, seriously. So here we go, we got secret people here. This is like the Secret Service. These people in England, they don't want to tell us what they do for a living. What do you do? Make it right. No, what make it right? This man's saying he's a removal man. Don't look like CIA or me or something. We'll find out in New York. No one wants to say what they do for a living, especially if they got a fucking suit on. Because you bet your life. When they hear my accent, it fucks them. They don't mind me for a little bit of entertainment, but they don't want to help my kind. They don't want to help me. I find it very difficult to get budgets for the films I make. I find it very difficult to get distribution for the films I make. You know what I mean? So, nobody's going to say, I don't know what, I don't do nothing, I'm a removals man. He's in a fucking Armani suit. He ain't a removal man, we know that. Even a fucking removal man weren't a fucking removal man. But you know in England we've got a democracy, yeah? In Israel you've got a democracy as well. So
not as well, less than England, but we wish to be a democracy still, like England.
We are
democracy.
Ah, you want to be, so your democracy is less than England, but you still want to be like England?
Yes.
I think
that most of the Israelis want to be democracy like England.
Good.
They wish to be,
which we are looked after and run by this establishment, by the Queen, you know, who take care of us all. And we take care of them as well. But how do you feel about Vanunu?
Vanunu?
Yeah. Because Vanunu was the man who exposed Israel's nuclear weapons to the world. He was in prison for 20 years for
yes,
it.
Yes.
So are you glad he's out of prison?
Well, he was punished.
Yeah.
He made his punished and he got free. I don't like
the hype?
The hoo-ha that he's making.
Yeah.
I think for himself.
But do you think as an Israeli, do you think that it's fair for Israel to have nuclear weapons, but not, say, Iran?
Yes.
We've got a scary lion, like this woman is in control of the lion, and she has a sickle in her hand. And this is the weapon that we have been seeing, the beheading of people, the terrible things that are happening in this war between the Jews, the Muslims, and the Christians. This is where our Queen lives. This is where the establishment sits. This is where the dysfunctional family that has been raping this country live. This is their abode. We've been seeing the people and the lower working class people who are on the streets.
They have nothing.
They're fuck all. We have no culture. Well, this gets stronger and stronger and stronger. I would like to ask the Queen something that's been really bothering me for a long time. We have a few soldiers here. Do you want to pick them soldiers up? Do you want to pick them soldiers up, Lily? Okay. One of those soldiers just walked past, and when he looked at me, he gave me that. Fuck you too. Right. So, what this place is, nice, isn't it? They work for her, you know what I mean? They're part of her bodyguard, in her army. So, I would like to ask the Queen, in all seriousness, when she said to Paul Burrell, be careful because there are dark forces at work here, I want to know exactly what she meant by that. Because this is the head of this country. This is the head, be it the figurehead, of the Church of England. Now, if you will tell us who these dark forces are, then us as Christians, we're very good at fighting dark forces. So you tell us who the dark forces are, Your Majesty, and we'll go and get them. Okay? Let's cross the road.
And yeah, we live here, you cunts. What are they gonna do? Fucking run us over? Wankers. Anyway. Now, don't matter fuck what you think about the Queen or her family or any of the other shit that goes with this. But there's one thing that I know, that this building was built and paid for by the lower working classes, who the upper classes call us ignorant, and on a consistent level take the piss out of us, so we're just giving them a little bit back. This is establishment. There's a strength. You know, if you look at the architecture, it's very Masonic. You know, this is very Masonic. And she was, in fact, the Queen, that is, the head of the Freemasons Ladies Association, or whatever they call it. And I believe that Prince Philip was the head of the males. And so this is how we show our power. And, you know, how, I don't, really, madam, I can't understand how you can even sleep at night when there are people on the streets and around the world and they have absolutely nothing, but you, in order to be a queen, in order to be a lord, you have to believe that you have a divine right to rule over the people. Now that means that you have been given, for those of you that don't know, to put it into layman's terms, into my language and into the people's language of this country that are in the majority, it means that God has given you permission to rule over everyone. I mean, what a load of fucking bollocks, madam. And oh, please, I hope that doesn't twang your fucking suspender belt, because you have come across a lot harsher things than what I'm talking about, because you have seen and danced with the fucking devil. And I know that, and you know that, and we all know where you're going and your kind. But we don't want to go there with you, because, as I've said before, you can't fight good with evil. And this is yours. This is yours. No one else can fucking say this is theirs. This doesn't belong to the people. This belongs to you. Yes, yes, madam, this belongs to you. And if I was talking to you personally, I would really get base with you, madam, because I really don't think you're a very nice person. Now, this is Bill Maloney, born and bred in England. Born in Lambeth Hospital, brought up in Peckham, Brixton and Lewisham. I'm one of the people that is paying towards your fucking breakfast and your dinner and all those fucking clothes you wear, while mothers weep for the deaths of their starving children. You know what I mean? We're fed up with your propaganda. People aren't believing you. And the people that work with you are pissy cunts and all, and I'm fucking angry now, so cut that little. Right, so I'm standing right outside the side gate of Buckingham Palace. When I was shooting over by the front gate, I had a police officer come up to me and said, what are you doing? And I said, I'm shooting some film, I'm a tourist. He said, you're not a tourist. And tried to make a chuckle of it with me. I said, yeah, I am, I'm a tourist. I'm just shooting a little bit of film. I'm just checking out Buckingham Palace and seeing what the coup is here. And then, and I've got the police pulling up right here now. So yeah, yes, I'm gonna go and have a little chat. I just had a police car pull up and the police called me over to them. And they said, there was another car behind it, just parked behind it, with a couple of guys in suits, and the police officer said, hello, what are you doing? And I said, I'm just shooting some film. So the police guy said, would you stay where you are, sir? In the car behind me, there are some gentlemen that are gonna wanna talk to you. And I said, who are they? And they said, they are police officers, sir. So they fucked off, and then the people got out of the car behind them, and a guy came over to me, and he said, what's going on, sir? And I said, my name's Bill Maloney, and I'm a filmmaker. And he said, right. So I gave him a little bit of the history, and he said, right. So I said, could you just come over with me and just over here? And he moved away, that he wanted to talk to me. And this police officer, in quite a middle-class accent, said to me,
He said, do yourself a favour, son, and fuck off. He said, otherwise you're going to be in trouble because you're going to get it. And that's exactly what he said to me, so I'm outside now. But I'm still doing my job because I'm a filmmaker, and you know, if we're all going to be frightened of people like that, then people like me won't get the facts to you. What just happened to me, it didn't frighten me, it just made me feel a little bit edgy, because it was the way the other guy in the car, you know, the police, they fucked off, and then the other guy, the way he was looking in the car, and then as he looked at me, he went like that, and as if he was going to pull something out, but he didn't pull anything out. He just took his hand out, put it in like that as he was looking at me in the car, took his hand out, sat back, relaxed, and gave me a snidey, fucking horrible smile. So, there you go, chaps, we've had the establishment on us today. Yeah. Give them something to do, wouldn't it? We just had quite a scare. As I was talking to you about the old Bill and telling you the story when we was outside Buckingham Palace, a car came past, bought us, carried us 400 metres, Lily and I, left the cameraman, Darren, and took us just round the corner and started asking some very, very strange questions. First of all, he asked me what column I was with. I didn't understand what he meant by column. And then he said to ask Lily what her religion was. And then what else was it he was asking?
Just asking, like, how long I've been in England, have you always lived in England, what are you doing here? What are you filming?
And I said to her, I went, Lil, say our now brown cow. And Lil went, our now brown cow. And I went to this geezer, this police officer, or secret service officer. I went, don't tell me she ain't fucking English, mate. And don't tell me I ain't fucking English. Now, you know, we're thinking, like, what are we going to do? Should we go this way? Should we go that way? These fuckers going to pick us up again? You know what I mean? So I've just phoned the producer and I've been telling her what's happened. And she said, just get the fuck out of here. So that's what we're going to do. But that wasn't very nice. And they, I wouldn't say they roughed me up a little bit, but one of them said to me, you're the tough guy, and I said, I'm a lot tougher than you, mate, but you got your pals with you at the moment. So he didn't like that, and he told me, he said, fuck off, you Mick cunt. Now, okay, we're done. And yes, I am fucking angry.
I'm just going to take you through to the apartment. We've just got here. I'm going to give you a slow pan round. It's a bit of a shithole, but I like it. Bill's downstairs at the moment, talking to the landlady, the crazy Jewish woman called Lita. He's on his way up, hopefully, and I'm going to get him. And he's not expecting it.
Lil, where are we?
Up here.
Huh?
Up here.
Oh, fucking hell, mate. I'll tell you what.
What?
See that old girl? She's fucking crackers.
Gotcha.
Oh.
Well, what's she saying?
You got fucking, you started early. The producer will love you. She's all, this is alright.
I think it's alright in here.
It's fucking strange, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit,
Right at the top of the house. Right, so, yeah. There's an old, we just got here. We had a nightmare flight.
We've got searches at the airport coming out, and we've got searches at the airport coming in. Coming out, they swabbed my the camera that we're using, the PD-170, which Lily's got out right fucking lively, bit of practice I suppose, Lil. So they swabbed that bag, my camera bag, three times. Said that there was a discrepancy on my fucking passport, right? This is the establishment. I quite like it here, Lil.
I think it's nice. Yeah. It's
all right, isn't it? Yeah. Hang on, let me tell you something. And then let me through. Then let us through. So, and then on the plane, we flew with BA. On the plane, you got to fill in this green form, you know what I mean? Because you're aliens going into the country and ask all these silly questions anyway. We didn't, well, Lil, naughty girl, filled him in for us on the plane. Just, you know, sort of half hour before he was landing. So she's filled him in, but you fucked up, didn't you? She's filled him in wrong. So that was it. Then when we got off the fucking, off of this side, John F. Kennedy Airport, I'm just seeing these pictures here.
They're great, isn't they?
Yeah, hang on. John F. Kennedy Airport. And then when we, you know, all the fucking old Bill there, like, proper, they all got their chewing gum, or sitting with their own passport, looking at her like that as you go through, you know what I mean? Etc., etc., etc. So anyway, let's have a little look here. The first thing I noticed when we come in here is, if you go back there, you'll get me and Billy. You're fucking the shot. Get over there, come on. Don't forget, remember, because poor Darren couldn't come, so we've got Lilly in training.
I know, I'm getting
there. All right, shut up while I'm talking. First thing I noticed is there's a picture of Billie Holiday here. Wonderful, wonderful woman, heroin addict, alcoholic, died at the age of 40 or something. And then here, we've got a picture of the wonderful, wonderful Jack Nicholson. Get back, Lil, stop screaming for the fucking shots. The wonderful Jack Nicholson. And over here is a picture of a fella. We don't know. Do you know who he is? I don't know who he is.
It's a bit like you.
He's a little bit like me, fucking hell. So there you go, like Lil says. So it's Billie Holiday, Jack Nicholson, and me. Right. So I can see a bath through here. Have you done a tour, Lil?
I've had little pan rounds in here, but I ain't gone in the bath.
So you have you shown the people the fucking
no,
where, right, I'm gonna show you where we live, right. This is the bathroom. It's a little bit there you go. First job done, fucking hell. You know what I mean? You never know. Fuck those rumours here. Can we hold the frame straight, please, darling, if we're going to do this camera? Right. Right, we've got the police outside. All right, cut that. Right, something very fucking strange has just happened. We just had a little visit from the police and they've given us our passports. Now, I thought we had our passports, but apparently they were found in the fucking, in the street where we got our cab from JFK Airport, and I do not believe that for one fucking minute. So, well, I don't know what that was about. Anyway, let's get back. Let's get back to showing, hang on, cut that, because that is a bit fat. Bollocks, what's going on here?
Bill! Bill? Bill? Hello? Bill, do you want some coffee?
What are you doing?
Do you want some coffee? Good morning. I just wanted to get you here. I just wanted to get you here. Do you want some coffee?
No.
Are you sure? You look like you need one.
Fucking hell.
Look at that for a hairstyle.
Morning.
Good morning.
What's happening?
Good morning, people.
Here we are in New York. This is Bill Maloney from Pine Mesh Films speaking to America from America. This is the fire hydrant. The fire hydrant was very predominant in most American films for me, you know? These were the things where you see the water gushing up. You'd see it in The Goodfellas, you see it in The Godfather, when Sonny beat the fuck out of the guy who had just bashed his sister up.
This
what's happening? Say something. Lil.
I'm here back in Times Square.
What do you think of New York, Lil?
Hey, I think it's a fucking great city.
Hey, where you going, honey?
Going over here.
What do you think of the people? What do you think of the accent?
I think it's great, sweetie. How you doing? I'm sorry. Hey, I just bumped Gail.
You're talking like a bum. You're in awe. Are you in awe?
Yes. In awe, not in awe.
Well, you're playing a fucking awe, aren't you? In the bronze. Here we go, really style done it all. Lovely police officer. Sorry. Yeah. I got told off for that. Fucking hell. Yeah, I got told up at any establishment, fuck them.
Okay, this is Toby. Tell me something about New York, Toby, and yourself.
Well, New York is very, very interesting. I was born in the Bronx.
Oh, and, tough girl.
Yeah, and I'm a school teacher. He was a school teacher.
What did you teach, Toby?
I taught special education.
Yeah.
In every level, in every world.
When you say special education, you mean to underprivileged kids?
Yes.
So if you was in our country, you would have taught me, because that's what I was.
Yeah, but I was in your country, and they don't pay teachers at all.
They don't pay them?
Yeah, looked for a job.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
That's one of the reasons I was engaged, but I decided to stay here. So, anyway, New York is fabulous and interesting.
If you could change one thing about America, Toby, just very quickly, what
Bush.
Would you change?
Bush.
Bush? Is that what everyone feels?
Well, that's the way everybody in New York feels. There are people elsewhere.
A bit more extreme.
Who are on the moon.
Yeah.
Like I was just in Hawaii. And nobody calls themselves a Republican anymore.
Oh my
God.
They
call themselves independents.
Oh my God. You know, I'm trying to get your accent. I love your New York accent. But you know what I believe, Toby? I believe that a society's compassion determines on.
Yeah,
what
but
it is
not,
all about.
We're not very compassionate.
Thank
Americans.
You, Toby. Thank you very much. Love you for that. Touch hands, as we say in London. This is Sean. I'm just down the road from Columbia University, and Sean's pulled me over because he fights for gay rights. He's going to say a few things. Go ahead, Sean.
So I'm with the Human Rights Campaign. We're America's largest gay and lesbian civil rights group. And today we're signing up new members, so that's why I stopped this old fellow here.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, in the USA today, in 31 states, it's perfectly legal to fire someone just because they're gay. So we're continuing our work against discrimination. Another interesting one for you is that murderers that are in prison currently get waivers to join the US military, but a gay American still cannot join his country. The good news is we have a bill in Congress right now that would change some of that, the Employment Non-Discrimination Act. And after 10 years, it has finally passed the House. But it is going where all good bills go to die, the Senate. So we face obvious opposition from Bush and the far right. So it's really important that we build the support of fair-minded people, and that is why we're out here today.
Well done, Sean.
So if you wanted to help,
well
right
done,
now,
Sean. Let me just say,
you could become
this
an HRC partner.
This is Bill Maloney, High Mash Films, speaking to America from America with my friend Sean. Okay, nice, Sean.
Right.
What can I do? You know, I don't want to paint a doom and gloom that there is no hope on this fucking planet, because there are good people. And I tell you something, you cannot beat good with evil. It will never work, because what goes round comes round. It's Bill Maloney for Pie Mash Films, speaking to America from America.
Hello, Mum. New York. I'm in New York. I'm going to get the New York accent.
Hello, Mummy. Hello, Daddy. I'm in New York at last. I've got my New York hat, I've got my cigarettes, I've got my little brandy, and I've got my chocolates. I'm going to fatten myself up for you. And if you're wondering where the lamp went, Mum, I've got it with me. I bought a bit of nanny with me. Just bought a bit of home with me.
Also, I've got to tell you that I call Maria, my producer and wife, Mum, because me Mum went on the game when I was 4. And it's just a little, what is it, Mummy? It's just a little sentimentality. It's not fuck all incestuous, is it, Mum?
I'm in my little room, and it's all nice and cosy, and Bill's next door. He's just watching some of the footage we've shot, and he's told me anything that's left on the tapes at the end of the day, I can have it, so I'm having a little chat with him. The landlady's great. Oh, she's Lita. She's this mad little Jewish woman, but she's fucking great, Mum. She's full of energy. She's got the fucking hots for Bill like mad. He's got her eating out of the palm of his fucking hand.
No problems, no, nothing. A little altercation with the police again. No, Mum, it's my character. I attract it, you know what I mean? Well, they searched the fucking the bags, we know that. Lil said to me, my bag's been searched. Before she went to bed, she went up and she said, I think my bag's been searched. Well, we're recording it. It's establishment, isn't it? They're trying to drive us mad. Well, things get out, don't they?
She's like, hey, Shreedy, how you doing up there? Everything okay? You need anything, just let me know. So, you know, we're getting heaters set up and everything. It's like fucking 2 below 0 out there, Mum. But it's nice and warm in there.
This is Bill Maloney speaking for Pine Mesh Films from America to America. Guess where I am now? I'm in the place where everybody told me not to go. I'm in Harlem. Don't tell me not to go to Harlem. I was brought up with fucking black people, you know what I mean? I was brought up in Brixton, Peckham and Lewisham. Mind where you're going there, darling, you're on the trash. So this is no different to me than Lewisham, Brixton, Peckham. Let me see if I give you a little pan. It seems a little bit more run down. Stay where you are. The people here, they seem to be a little bit more depressed. You don't get so many smiles in the street, you know? If I'm walking through South East London, anywhere in London really, people will smile at me. I can give people a wink and I can chat and have the crack with them. The crack being, you know. But you can't do that, you know? Here it is a little bit nervy, you know? I don't know if they're gonna take offense. You pull a camera out, you know? But I don't wanna look too touristy. You pull a camera out, you fucking lost it, you know what I mean? It seems all right, it seems quite peaceful. His car's pulled up just behind Lilly. She's shooting on the camera, and the guys are right bang on us. I think they're wondering what we're doing, so I'm just ignoring them like I would until it kicks off, and then if that motherfucker decides to pull a gun out on me, then that's when I run. No, everything's cool here.
That's 40 with them little looking face. I was playing in the air, little mama, what you drank? I know that you were free, but you know I ain't gonna play shit. See, my game is outrageous. I got to the crib and exchange some fuck faces. But it wasn't the use for me to rush the bus one because I wanted her to have an eruption. Sex, you won't eruption.
Now, Wolves. That's it, man. Now, Wolf, take it. Give the man $10. Nice, man. Right. If a bus comes, you tell us. Virginia, how long have you lived in Harlem all your life?
53 years.
53 years?
Yeah.
And so you must have seen a lot of changes, Virginia.
Oh, yes, very much so.
So if there was one thing that you could change, what would you change?
I would change the attitude of the rich people to think that Harlem is a bad place. White people always been in Harlem.
Yeah.
They always come to Harlem.
Yeah.
You know. So yeah, we got bad people in every race.
Of course.
You know?
Well, Virginia, I'm not gonna bother you anymore. Is this your bus?
No, I'm leaving 101.
Okay. But thank you very much for talking
to us.
And I think that what you're saying about the rich people's attitude changing, I agree with you very much, Virginia. And love you very much.
And enjoy your stay.
Thank you very much, Virginia. Have a nice day. Bye-bye. I'm bang in the middle of Harlem. Now, over to my left, it seems to me that there are still some pretty run-down shops. There's a lot of places. I mean, Harlem, compared to the other places that I've been visiting, especially at White Quarters, it's still very run-down. There seems to be a lot of poor people here still. And there's a lot of people here. Listen, I'm just going to give this guy $1 if I can't be standing outside this guy. And there's an eye missing, and I'm going to give this man $1. There you go, sir. How are you, sir? And what happened to your eye? Do you mind me asking? I'm from England. Yeah, and how's your healthcare been?
Fair.
Fair? Have you been paid for what you're doing? You know, for your injury?
I have a disability, yes.
Yeah?
March
7th,
yes.
Okay, well, it's a pleasure to meet you, sir, and I won't trouble you anymore. Thank you for talking to me. You know, I'm just getting this fucking feeling that people don't want to... It's not that they don't want to talk. I think there's a fear. There is definitely a fear in this country. And it's not just the black and Hispanic people. You know, there seems to be one rule for the rich and one rule for the poor here. Hello, sir. well, you know, I'm not being like derogatory to black people. Let's have a look. If we look down here, we can see like, I want you to come over here, Lil, and then shoot over my shoulder. So we see this is a pretty run down area. Let's go round me, Lil. Let's come round, get this moving. Down area, you know, and people are saying to me, especially the white people, oh, Harlem is a lot better, Harlem is a lot safer, you know, and I'd like to know what they're doing to make it like that. I don't know whether it's just the brutality of the police. I mean, I've got some crazy film that I shot in Columbus Circus, you know, downtown, where the rich people are, and I mean the fucking rich people, you know, and the police show this show of force, which reminded me of like stormtroopers, you know, and I think that is like a jackboot bing on the back of the fucking black man's neck saying, if you don't do as you're told, we're gonna fuck you. This is Bill Maloney, Playmash Films, speaking to America from America.
Anne,
that's a nice name, Anne.
Yeah,
I can see that, Anne. How are things here for you? What's wrong with you? Are you on welfare?
SSI.
Huh?
Social Security.
How much a week do they give you here, Anne, in America, this rich country? How much a week do they give you?
For what?
For your welfare. How much money do you get? Yeah, we're filming you, baby. You tell me, how much do you get a week? We're trying to help.
$50.
They give you $50 a week to live on? You got a drug problem or anything like that, Anne?
No, I joined a program.
You join a program? Yeah, what, a drug program?
No, it's everything.
Everything. What was your thing? Was you alcohol? Was it drugs?
Smoking crack.
You was a crack, you're a crack cocaine addict, yeah?
Once in a while.
Once in a while. And so it fucked your life up, really, yeah?
In the beginning, yeah, but my life won't come back. Got a new apartment.
Yeah, so you're doing all right now. Things are looking good for you, eh? Well, listen, whatever. You've got people in England at least, and you know, we think about you, you know, because I was on the street as well when I was a kid, you know, and I fought back in, and I hope it all goes well for you, okay?
Bye now.
Bye. God bless you, darling. I came to New York as a filmmaker, you know, my film's being shown up in fucking Manhattan. And the strange thing is, this is called Uptown, and where the money is called Downtown. Now that is fucking propaganda, because this town is fucking down, and that town is up. But if I had to choose to live with those in the downtown, I'd rather fucking live with those in the uptown, if that makes a sense. This is Bill Maloney speaking for Pine Mash Films to America from America. And the lovely Lilly Star. Right, we're just on our way to the opening night of the festival. We're looking forward to it, Lil.
We are.
I think I look rather pucker. I've got my coat on. I've got a suit on. I've got the fucking braces on. I'm showing these yanks how to do it, you know what I mean? And a very nice silk scarf as well. And the lovely Lilly. Do you want to do one of those up?
No, don't do that. Fuck off.
Are you sure?
That'd be alright.
Do you think you should do one up? Well, maybe you should do one up. Anyway, when we come back, we're going to give you a full report of what happened. What we're looking for is nominations, energy, and fucking people.
It's going to be pucker.
And don't get drunk. Yeah, and no fucking about. I told her she's got to be in at 9 o'clock, alright? And don't bring no men here.
Volare. Oh. Cantare, oh, 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 let's fly way up to the clouds, away from the maddening crowds. We can sing in the glow of a star that I know of, where lovers enjoy peace of mind. Let us leave the confusion and all disillusion behind. Just like birds of a feather, a rainbow together we'll find. Volare, oh, oh. E cantare, oh, oh, oh. No wonder my happy heart sings, your love has given me wings. Penso che io sogno così non ritorne mai più.
Well, I think that was a very good evening, Lil, don't you?
I think it went well, yes. It went very well.
In Lil's word, as she put it, we were mobbed. We were, weren't we?
Swarmed, like flies around shit.
So, Lunatic is out. People know about the film Lunatic. I think they're finding it very interesting at the festivals because we're shooting with no edits, like Alfred Hitchcock did with a film called Rope in 1947. But even then, he had a $1.4 million budget. And we shot this on 40K. He only used one location as well. But, you know, he was at a little bit of a disadvantage, Alfred, because his cameras were weighing, you know, maybe a quarter of a ton. Whatever difference that fucking made. But I'm just making excuses for Alfred, you know what I mean? Anyway, everyone was bang on us, you know, and there was another film called Camilla's Kiss, and it was quite funny, really, because there was a little Jewish-American, New York, actually, director, and he was all right, he was quite sweet,
he was
really.
Right,
and he just said, hey, how comes they've come to interview you, but they haven't interviewed me? I don't have your energy. You got the energy. That's why they're interviewing you. Well, I don't think so, my son. I think it's all about the fucking film, to tell you the truth. You know what I mean? We have knocked out a proper piece of work here. I would just like to say while I've been on the streets, I have seen a lot of beggars. And and it seems to be the opposite to London, where the beggars and the street people were predominantly white. Here in New York, they are black. Mm. And I actually haven't seen one white beggar. No. So that's a little bit sad, you know. So maybe what we're being told around the world about this great democracy isn't so great. So anyway, I'm going to get you. If you're not, if you're fucking about with these people, Mr. Bush, whatever you're doing, you and your fucking establishment, we're coming to get you. Yeah? Pie and Mash Films. Yes. Love it! I'm at the world famous Apollo Theatre. Just across the road, there's a shop called the House of Hoops, where crowds gathered. Selling some cheap shoes today, right in the middle of Harlem here.
I just wonder,
how people feel about us being here, you know, because there's definitely an atmosphere, you know, but I don't feel uncomfortable, but I am on my toes, as we say back in London, you know what I mean? Now, I've got some guys coming across the street. I don't know if they're going to talk or what, you know. I don't think so. It's like my street sense is telling me to do certain things, you know. Hello, mate. My name's Bill Maloney, and I'm from England. I'm a filmmaker, and I'm over here for a couple of weeks. And I've been, you know, I've just come into Harlem because I was brought up in a black area. What's your name?
Raymond.
Nice to meet you, Raymond. Raymond, what's America like now? What's the healthcare like for black people?
Not so good. Everybody ain't doing getting too much healthcare, you know what I'm saying? Because the economy's rating so high. Insurance on. Well, health insurance is skyrocketing.
Yeah, so.
You know what I'm saying? So it's hard for a lot of black Americans, really, to get health insurance for kids, you know what I'm saying? Because they're trying to live this lifestyle that's here right now. $1,500 for one studio, and it's crazy.
So what the politicians are telling us is bullshit, really.
You take your judgment on that one. You know, I'm not a hard politician.
But Raymond, who are we going to go for? Would you go for Obama or would you go for Hillary?
Obama.
Obama, of course. You know, I think I'm starting to agree with you. Black people in England are a lot better off than black people in America. Your minimum wage is about $7 an hour. Let's get Raymond.
Let me tell you, my minimum wage is $8 an hour, and I don't live out here no more. I live upstate.
Right, so that's upstate. But there are 5 states in America, I was told, that have no minimum wage,
No minimum wage.
You know, so if your minimum wage here is $8 an hour, that works out in England to about £4 an hour.
Okay.
So in England, we have, our minimum wage is the equivalent to about $10 or $11 an hour.
Yeah.
But the point is, Raymond, at the moment, the pound is very strong against the dollar.
Yeah,
you understand?
Right now, yeah, it is. So you're a weak individual right now, coming
exactly.
to a lot of country states.
So your money doesn't go as far as it did.
As it used to.
Right, and I was listening to Mayor Bloomberg yesterday on TV, and he was saying that he's going to have a zero tolerance on fake goods, you know, like Hugo Boss and Armani being sold, because, you know, these big companies, poor people, they're being robbed, aren't they, Raymond? So I would like to see, and I think that maybe you might like to see, Mayor Bloomberg showing a low tolerance on poverty. What do you think of that one?
Nah, I don't know. It's still poverty out here.
I know. Well, let's see what we can do. Raymond, thank you very much
for talking to me.
And England.
All right.
Nice. All right. We love
you, man.
Thank you very much. It's not right here. I don't give a fuck what the white guys are saying. You know, and I'm saying white guys, black guys, because you have to differentiate, because that is how it is in this fucking country. And to see, you know, the richest country in the world, and we are the fourth richest country in England, and let's get the fucking minimum wage up. Where are you, Tony Blair, you fucking prick? Okay. There's an angry man. A sick man and an angry man. Anyway, I'm just sort of a quarter of a mile from Columbia University, where all the rich people's children are being educated, and now I'm in Harlem. This is, I suppose, the equivalent to what they have up there. This is an education centre where black people can come and improve their reading and their writing, etc. But there is a very strange feel to the place. And I don't think it's fair. I just feel uncomfortable here, not as a white person, because I come from a black area myself. I feel for this place. This place needs more money and it needs regeneration. So let's see what we can do. Thank you.
Hello, darling. How are you? How are you?
Yeah? You live here in Harlem?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah, are things bad here, or are things good here, or are they getting better?
They're bad here.
They're bad here? They're bad for you, baby?
Yeah.
Yeah? So, what do you do? You sit here all day?
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, you're on welfare?
Yeah.
What kind of money do you get? How much would they give you for a week on welfare, say?
$102.
That's not a lot of money, is it? Yeah. Well, listen, it's been nice talking to you. And this little red thing you have here, what's that for? AIDS?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Well, good luck. Good luck. I'm from England, I'm a filmmaker, and I just come into Harlem, and I just wanted to talk to some black people and see what's going on, because what's going on isn't what we're being told around the world, you know? So, what's your name?
Jackie.
A beautiful name for a beautiful woman, Jackie. Bye-bye. I was just talking to a lady, as you saw, called Jackie. She's living on the street. And welfare, you can obviously see that this lady has got sort of mental problems, physical problems, but she still has a sort of a compassion about her, where she cares about things, that she's wearing the anti-AIDS badge, if you like, and that really touched me there. So I've just come around the corner for a minute. You know, we're shooting stuff on this camera, and we're getting hooted, and we've had a little bit of abuse here, but not too much, you know. We've had people telling us to fuck off, but they're not black people telling us to fuck off, let's put it like that. And Jackie touched me, and she's getting $102 a week on her welfare, you know. $102 in England works out to about £50 a week. £50 a week. But if you could change one thing in America, what would you change?
I'd change the violent criminal enactments that are allowed to exist because of our authoritative system that pays no attention to that which is in their power to do so.
And what was that? When you're talking about the establishment, you're talking about the government?
I'm talking about our civil liberties.
Yeah.
I'm talking about from the civil all the way to the federal.
Yeah.
They allow these criminal, they allow crime and violence to to exist in America because it's profitable.
Because it's profitable. So are you saying that if black and white are fighting each other, it keeps the eye off of the top people?
Exactly.
There you go, man.
Exactly.
Nice talking to you, brother.
Pleasure.
Good luck. Good
exactly.
luck.
That's from England.
Good luck,
yes.
man. What's your name?
Marvello.
Marvello. That's a good name.
Hello again, mummy. I'm sitting in my little room. I'll just shut off for a minute there.
Where's my fucking money?
I don't know where your money is.
Where's my fucking money?
Don't come here shouting. Where's your money?
I'm not shouting.
I don't know where your money is.
Oh, I'm not shouting. I'm just
you
not...
are shouting. You just come fucking... in my fucking room.
Where's the dollars?
I don't know.
Where's the fucking dollars?
I don't know, Bill. You gave me budget today and there's about $4 left, alright? Don't fucking wank at me. Oh, get him his fucking handbag. Fuck off out again or something.
I ain't fucking off out.
Yeah, go
on,
fuck off.
Fuck off yourself. Bollocks, cunt.
Yeah, got more bollocks than you, you fucking prick. What am I supposed to say if Maria phones up? Oh, don't want to fucking answer that one, eh? A surprise, a fucking surprise, eh? You make me fucking laugh, you do. Where's my fucking money? Don't I get no fucking Lily time or what?
I'm just having my morning coffee and I've noticed something very strange. Here we are. If I pan the camera, on the wall in Starbucks, there's a picture. And as I zoom in on the picture, that is the all-seeing eye, which is on the dollar bill and is on the wall as a piece of art in Starbucks. And that's a little bit scary.
I've just found this little leprechaun with the shamrock in a pot because St. Patrick's Day is coming up. So this has made this filmmaker just a little bit more comfortable and just chilled me out just a little bit. Bill Maloney, Pie Mash Films, speaking to America from America. Shlanka. In my next film, The Brass, there's a line that's quoted. It's, suffer little children who come unto me, John the Divine. This is the church, John the Divine. And I was brought up in the Catholic institutions, but I wasn't brought up in the prestigious Catholic institutions. I was brought up in the Catholic institutions that were there for the poor. That's where all the abuse happened. That's where kids were fucked with by the priests and the nuns as well. We don't hear much talk about the nuns, but some of them were the most brutal women that I ever met in my life. The beatings that I took from nuns, you know, and they would use sticks, belts, anything they could, the hard side of a hairbrush. And then when I look at this and what it's supposed to represent, you know, Jesus Christ, Jesus, Mary, Joseph, the Holy Ghost, the Son of God, the only begotten Son of God. It's all bollocks. He was a good man. Jesus was a prophet. I wear a crucifix, but I wear my crucifix not because I'm a Catholic and not because I believe in Jesus being the only begotten Son of God. I wear it because it represents the suffering around the world. In Saudi Arabia, they're still crucifying people. They're still stoning people. We have the Saudi royal family. These are the people our queen will shake hands with. She will shake hands with them. You know what I mean? And surprise, surprise, Harry's come back. Oh my God, who would have guessed it? They'll send our kids to war. Not too dangerous for our kids, but too dangerous for their fucking kids. This is Bill Maloney, Pie Mash Films, speaking to America from America. It is very, very, very strange and very, very uncomfortable to me. If we can just get a shot of this head upside down. Now, we have a head of a devil with horns and just above him is there's a crab claw that has him about the throat. Now, this is a children's sculpture area. That's fucking weird. I just had to step out of that sculpture area that was apparently done by children in kindergarten. And this is right next to the Church of John the Divine. So you have a massive religious church, Catholic church, next to what appears to me to be a garden that is full and encrusted with satanic and demonic sculptures that is being credited to children. Now, when the Queen said dark forces are at work here, this is scary fucking stuff, you know what I mean? I think we should get her into court and we should talk to her and question her on what she meant exactly by that about our country. The bells, the bells, the bells. This is the establishment around here. This is Columbus University or Columbus College, whatever way you want to put it. This is where, like, some of the top people, you know, the lawyers, all the brightest young kids, all, you know, I think it seems to be quite a Jewish-oriented place, and the Catholics, and it's establishment. It just says establishment to me. The buildings are so powerful, and as we move down the line towards Harlem, where there's no money, they got fuck all. I saw a black man sleeping in a laundromat last night. When I walked past this morning, 15 minutes ago, he's still sleeping in that fucking laundromat. Outside the laundromat, around the world, two doors away from the laundromat, there was a guy in a wheelchair. So this guy in a wheelchair said, "Hey, buddy, can you spare me a buck?" So I said, "Yeah, of course I can, mate." So I give him a $20 bill. He said, "I have nowhere to live. I'm sleeping on the street." This man's in a wheelchair. That's the fucking underbelly of America. And then we go into the supermarkets. You know, it's unbelievable, the choice, the food, the saturated fat. These people love fucking saturated fat. It's a greedy country. It's a prosperous country. But the people here, you don't get smiles on the street like you do in London, you know. You can stop and you can have the crack with someone. That's the crack in the Irish term, you know what I mean? Here, you smile at someone, you think, they look like they want to fucking shoot you, you know what I mean? The police officers, the old Bill, they want to make their fucking mind up here, you know what I mean? Up where all the tourists are. If a couple of girls go up to a police officer and they say, "Hey, can we have a picture taken with you?" They go, sure, honey. And then they straighten themselves up, you know, check their guns, give it all that bollocks, chew their chewing gum faster, the cunts. And then when I go up and say, "Can I have a picture with you?" They go, not today, sir. That's what they do. And the bells are subsiding. What is become of America?
We'll talk about something that's got a bit of fucking depth to it, Lil, you know what I mean? You're talking like a cunt at the moment. I'm going out.
Where are you going?
I'm going out. Mind your own fucking business.
Where are you going out?
I'm going out. I'll do what I want to fucking do. I'm in fucking New York. What's this fucking
Russia? Yeah, so am I.
Fuck off, Lil.
Well, you ain't got the right to know where you're fucking going.
Fuck
just
off,
leave me
Lil.
Here.
Lil, fuck off. Oi, you're too miserable.
And you're miserable. Well, fuck you too, then.
You're miserable in the morning, you're miserable at night, and you're miserable in the day.
Well, go on, fuck off, then.
It's a bollocks,
cunt. Fuck off. It's all bollocks. It's all fucking bollocks. All of it. Just get so passionate about things, and I know what he's doing is right, but a lot of people don't agree with that. A lot of people, we've been approached by police, police cars have just pulled up alongside us, they've pulled him, and I don't even think he's telling me everything that they've asked him, or maybe you don't want to worry me, I don't know. You know, Mum, it ain't all hunky-dory out here.
And then I'm walking past, like, you know, I'm just seeing the Medicare thing, so you're obviously bringing healthcare.
Exactly, for seniors, people who are disabled.
If they have no money?
That belongs to them because they have been working for 10 years here constantly, for 40 quarters.
Right.
Yeah.
So if they've been here for 10 years, then you can help them.
Yes. Yeah.
If they've been here for 9 years.
No, then there's other type of plans. Yeah. Also, what we do is we work with Medicare.
Yeah.
And Medicaid, yeah. Which means that we can provide whoever has Part A, Part B of medical.
Right.
Then we can help them out because for additional, like for $10 of food, we could help them out for taxi.
Who funds you? Who funds you?
No, the state and federal.
The state is funded, so that's the equivalent to our, like, our National Health Service. We have a National Health Service, which is very strong.
Yeah.
But what's
yeah.
happening, they're trying to privatise it like you've got in America. But we're standing strong on this, you know what I mean? We're not having our NHS service being privatised because America's example to us, especially to me and people like me as filmmakers or journalists, we know it will go bad for those that have not.
Yeah,
got
exactly.
it. It seems like a dejected area. It's people have been neglected here. I think they have quite a big problem with the welfare system. I've seen a lot of black people with limbs missing, eyes missing, and pushing themselves around in cheap wheelchairs. A lot of the problem is diabetes, because they can't afford the medicine, so they just cut the fucking limbs off. That's it, you know what I mean? To give them the treatment to maybe save a limb, to save an eye. They're not getting it. That's why it's so important that back in England, we got to preserve the National Health Service. Otherwise, it's going to fuck us all. It's going to fuck us, it's going to fuck our children, not the rich. And I'm fed up with the rich people taking the best of our doctors after we've trained them. You know what I mean? They're taking our doctors, our best nurses into the private health. Make them sign a contract. If we train a doctor, we're paying for his fucking training in our taxes. And us working classes, lower working classes, we're in the majority in England. So let's not turn England into the underbelly of America, and let's keep it straight. Tony Blair's, Margaret Thatcher's, George Bush's, they don't give a fuck about us, and we don't give a fuck about them. And let's get real and preserve our National Health Service. Amen. And what's the minimum wage here?
It depends.
$8.
On the minimum, it's $8.
Yeah.
That just got raised. It used
right.
to be $5.15.
That's right.
Right. So, and this is the richest country in the world. And
I don't think this is the richest.
You don't?
That's what people portray it.
Yeah.
It's not.
But you know, you find out about these billionaires, the guy who invented the umbrella that goes into a drink, he's a billionaire. The guy who invented the metal coat hanger, he's a billionaire. The guy who invented the carton, he's a billionaire.
Right.
Should people like this be responsible for amounts of cash that could save millions of people's
sure.
lives? It's not
that
right,
is
help.
It? It's not right. Right. It's just like the basketball players. Look how much money they get.
Yeah.
You know, they have the basketball players, then they have the baseball players, but yeah. meanwhile, you have people starving.
You know, us white boys, we're the ones with the fucking money. And let's release a little bit of it. You know, don't just like say, oh, we're going to give you, oh, here, take this and kiss my ass and like do this and thank you, sir, and thank you, ma'am. Fuck all that. What is the equality in that? What is this bullshit going on here? Yeah, you know, I might be coming across angry and an antagonist there, but, you know, I'm not as fucking antagonistic as George Bush. And everyone's talking about you, son, and you got to listen. And I'm calling you son because you've never become a man and you never will become a man, and you need a kick in the bollocks, mate. This is Bill Maloney from Pine Mash Films speaking to America for America. Oh, fuck, I don't know what I'm fucking saying. The fucking camera bag, and they put it in this thing. I said, what are you looking for? They said explosives. I said, what do you mean explosives? So they said, we're looking for explosives, sir. Don't worry about it. Well, fuck the festival, Steve. Listen to what I'm saying here. Listen, yeah, I am worried about something, Steve. I've been threatened. I've been threatened on more than one occasion. They're government people. No, I don't want you to come out. What can you do? Who do I phone? Who can I phone and ask about it, Steve? What do? Do I go to the police and say, listen, I think that you lot are fucking... I'm not even going to say it. I'm not even going to say it. No, I'm not frightened, but I'm not comfortable.
Yes, of course I'm going to keep shooting. I'm going to fucking shoot everything I fucking can. Everything I can see on the fucking street. I'm just telling the truth about this bollocks, what's going on in this fucking country. People are keep talking about all the money's going to fucking Iraq, you know what I mean? There's no money. That's what all the blacks are saying. That's what they're being fed. There is no money for you. It's going to Iraq. It's going to Afghanistan. It's going to fucking Somalia. It's going here. It's going everywhere except for the fucking poor people here. Listen, Steve, whatever happens, get my fucking work out. You understand? Get my work out. I'm going. I'm just outside Columbia University. The establishment is very strong here. The Jewish establishment, the Catholic establishment, etc. On the dollar bill, we have here the all-seeing eye, King Solomon's Mines, Freemasonry. When I look around the architecture here... Got it? I see exactly the same thing. Let's do it again. The all-seeing eye on the dollar with the pyramid. And there it is up there. This is Bill Maloney, High Mass Films, speaking to America from America. Come on, Lil. Stay there. There seems to be a lot of pyramids incorporated into the local architecture around Columbia University. And it makes me wonder whether it has anything to do with the Illuminati, with masonry, you know, Freemasonry is alive. The pyramid, the King Solomon's mines, the all-seeing eye on the dollar. This is predominant. This is very, very scary. And we're allowing it to get stronger. And as America becomes stronger and stronger and stronger and richer and richer and greedier, it makes me very, very concerned for the welfare of the human race. I'm not saying this lightly, I am seriously concerned. Behind Lilly, there's a police car that's pulled up. Now, I don't think that I look like a criminal, and neither does Lilly, my camera woman. But they seem to be on me, and the guy's beckoning me towards him. So we're going to end this now. Bill Maloney, Pine Mash Films, speaking to America from America. This is Bill Maloney speaking for Pine Mash Films to America from America. This is another example. Again, there is no health care here that is sufficient for the lower working classes, for the underprivileged. But once again, when we come to the rich people's children, where they are educating them, at places like Columbia University, so that they can continue to rule this world we live in and maintain their fiscal dominance over us all. This, when I go to England, people there can't get any dental treatment. This place is just for the fucking students. Just for the fucking students. Down there is Harlem. This is Bill Maloney. No, wait till I start moving. Wait till I start going. This is Bill Maloney's. Come up here again. I'm watching the street, I'm watching. Stay there until I start fucking. Just wait. Cut it. Say rolling.
Rolling.
This is Bill Maloney. Come here, you're too far away from me. Now, you got me?
Yeah.
This is Bill Maloney, Pine Mash Films, speaking to America from America. I'm on the campus of Columbia University. The black to white ratio of students is very, very low. I have to speak very low because I've got a couple of security people on me. They don't want me to say what I'm saying. I've already been pulled for talking about this. Just down the road, a quarter of a mile, we have Harlem. There are black people, men, women, children. I've seen people who had their limbs chopped off, eyes taken out. They are in wheelchairs. They are living on the streets in wheelchairs because they have no health care. This university is predominantly for the middle and upper middle classes, the rich. This is what they have. This, remember, is just a university. They have their own fucking ambulances. This is just for the university. The people
who live here and built this country are getting fuck all. There was a 13-year-old girl begging on 42nd Street last night. I gave her $20 and told her to go home. She looked like I was Jesus. She looked at me like I was her fucking saviour. This country has an underbelly to it that is so sinister. I don't even know how to describe it myself. I've cried here. I've been here for 8 days and I've cried almost every single day at the deceit and the deception that is being fed to us by our politicians. Been approached on the street again today by the police. I think they want me out of the country. They don't like what I'm saying. I'm starting to fear for my safety. I just want to make this tape. I just want to tell my daughter that I love her. I love you, Regan. I love you very much. I love you more than anything. And my wife, Maria. I've been with you for 30 years, Maria. And I just hope that my mouth hasn't fucked everything. Like, I can't watch these people suffering. I don't know what it is. It's just something in me. I just can't fucking leave it alone. There's something very big going on this planet at the moment. I believe there's going to be a nuclear conflict. The Americans can't handle it anymore. The Israelis can't handle it anymore. They're not strong enough. Too much pizza and central eating. They need nuclear weapons and someone's gonna let one fucker off soon. And if it's not in Iran, it'll be in India. I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know what's gonna happen to me. I don't know if Lily's safe here. I listen to her phoning her mum at night. I've been threatened. I've been threatened with arms. I'm not saying any more than that. But if anything happens to me, it's the establishment. They seem to love the royal family here. Socialism is not American, apparently. I don't know what is fucking American. I hate this place. I hate this fucking New York. Everything has taken second place. My survival instincts now are just telling me to get home. I've got 3 days to go. I'm just going to continue shooting on the street. It's all I can do. As if I'm predominant, they might leave me alone.